The topic of this session is constants, variables, and data types of Java programming language. Constants refers to fixed values. Constants in Java refers to fixed values that do not change during the execution of a program. For example, there is an expression called a equal to a plus b plus 5. In this expression, the number 5 is called as a constant or a fixed value. The values for a and b that I am going to input from the keyboard and those values will be added with the value, constant value, which I am going to provide, and the whole thing will be stored in a variable a. The expression will be like a equal to a plus b plus 5. So a value, b value keyboard in the input martini. Adike 5 and a value extra a number add agate. The whole total will be stored in another variable, final variable a. If 5 and then anin use martini, it is called as a fixed value or the constant which do not change during the execution of a program. Nan already coding develop madbekadrene fix madidini. The constant value should be this much up. And you have several categories of constants in Java, like integer constants. There are two major categories, numeric constants and character constants. Under numeric constants, again you have two subtypes, like integer constant and floating point or real constant. Then under character constants, again there are two subtypes, character constant and string constant. First, we will take up an integer constant under the section numeric constant. Numeric constants li you have two subtypes, integer and floating point constant. Adrilli we will look into integer constants now. As you know, the integer values antandre these are the numbers without any decimal point. Actually it's a sequence of digits. Nan 1 2 3 4 anta input madidre 1 2 3 4 1234 annadu it's an integer value. 1 2 3.4 anta hakidre it becomes a floating point or the real value. An integer constant refers to a sequence of digits. There are three types of integers, namely decimal integer, octal integer, and hexadecimal integer. Idrilli again subcategories. Main thing is constant. There you have two subcategories, numeric constant and character constant. Under numeric constants, you have again two subcategories, that is integer constant and floating point constant. Under integer constant, again you have three kinds of categories, that is decimal integer, octal integer, and hexadecimal integer constants. Example for decimal integer is 1, 2, 3, as I explained you before. 0, it can be 0 also. If I say 654321, it's also an example for integer constant. And as an example for octal integer constant, zero, 435, 0551, an octal integer constant. I think you know about hexadecimal numbers and octal numbers. From the language C programming language, or from the language C++ also provides numerous classification for constants. It's a set of digits from 0 to 7. 0435 antanan type madidre number starting with the number 0, set of numbers starting with 0 antandre it's an octal integer constant. 0x in the start adre set of numbers, it's called as hexadecimal integer constant. So these are the three categories under integer constant. This integer constant is a part of numeric constant. Next, another category under numeric constant is real or the floating point constant. It's a number with decimal point. These numbers are represented by numbers containing fractional parts like 17.548. It's an example for real constant. A real number may also be expressed in exponential or scientific notation. For example, you have a number 215.65. It may be written as 2.1565 exponential to the power 2. As you have learnt in your algebra classes, this value, if you want to write it in a exponential form, 215.65, you will write it as 2.1565 e to the power 2 or e2. The portion which consists of decimal numbers or integer part which is before the decimal point is called as an mantissa, and the number after the decimal point is called as an exponent. Another example would be like 3118 e3 and the exponential values. A floating point constant comprises of whole number admele one decimal point, admele fractional part, to ending alli exponent part. So another example, 1.5e+5. 1 is a whole number, point is a decimal point, 5 is a fractional part, e plus 5 is an exponent part. So this is about real constant category or floating point constant category. So we finished off with the categories of numeric constants, that is integer constant and real or floating point constant. Next, we will move on to character constant category. Under character constant category, again you have two options like character constants and string constants. under character constants, there is single character constant. It's a enclosure of a single character within a single quote, and a string constant. It's a collection of characters, alphabets, digits, special characters and blank spaces within double quotes. So these are the examples for single character constants and string constant. There is another set of category called backslash character constant. These backslash character constants as alphabets preceding with a backslash character from your keyboard. For example, while doing C programming, at the end of every printf statement, you would use slash n symbol. Slash n symbol. Suppose there is a function called printf, which is printing this statement, enter the value of a. Before enclosing that statement with the double quotes, you end that particular statement with slash n. Then when you run that particular program, after you will be visible the statement, enter the value of a on the screen, and cursor will move on to the next line. The cursor will not blink on that current line itself. Automatically, after printing the statement, enter the value for a, it will move on to the next line. So that is an example for backslash character constant. These character combinations are also known as escape sequences. We have slash b for typing backspace. To move the cursor to the previous line or backspace, instead of making use of backspace key from your keyboard, you can use slash b, similar to slash n. So these are the different kinds of constant categories available in the Java language. Next topic is variables. Variables are nothing but identifiers denoting memory or the storage location. A variable is an identifier that denotes a storage location used to store a data value. There are some rules followed to create identifiers or variables. For example, I'll take a set of collection of characters. Collection of characters is nothing but it frames a word like average, height, total underscore height, class strength. Without giving space in between, you should make use of the variable names. It should be like, it should be continuous. ಈಗ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಟೂ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒನ್ ವರ್ಡು, ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒನ್ ವರ್ಡು. ನಾನು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಯೊಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ರೂಲ್ ಫ್ರೇಮಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್ಸ್. ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಜಾಯ್ನಿಂಗ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟೂ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸ್ಕೋರ್, it creates one single word called as class underscore strength. or else I can take, if I don't want to use the combination of two words, I can consider a single word like height, average, average, average is a single English word. I can take it as a variable. I can declare it as a variable name, which is a identifier, which is used to recognize a memory location in the programming language. Here there are some rules for framing these variables. Like a variable may consist of alphabets, digits, and underscores and dollar character. It must not begin with a digit. There is a difference between uppercase and lowercase characters. It should not be a keyword. White space is not allowed. That is what I told while taking the example of class strength. Variable names can be of any length. So this is about variables. Suppose you are writing a program to calculate the area of the room. So what are the variables that you are going to declare? Obviously, length and breadth. The name of the length, the name length consists of 6 characters, L-E-N-G-T-H. The word breadth consists of some 7 characters, B-R-E-A-D-T-H. So these names, what I have told just now, length and breadth, these names are called as identifiers. These names are identifying the memory locations to store the values of length and breadth. This is about variable declaration rules. In the next session, you will learn how to declare those variables. Next topic is data types. Data types in Java consists of 2 major categories, like primitive and non-primitive data types. Under primitive, you have again classification like numeric and non-numeric category. Under numeric category, you have integer and floating point data types. Under non-numeric category, character and boolean data types. Under non-primitive, classes, arrays, interfaces, these are the things which comes under non-primitive or derived data types. You can refer study materials for the examples. I hope you have understood this concept. We'll move on to next session. Thank you all.